Now the hometown Red Sox line up in this one. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, I'm definitely excited to watch Rafael Devers in this one. He's an imposing figure with a bat in his hands, always seems to turn in a good at-bat, and he can do a lot of damage when he barrels up the ball.
Here's Michael Brantley, hitless in four tries in the ball game yesterday.
Michael Brantley.
Shot here as this is sent towards second. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Next up for the Red Sox, Joshua Stewart. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Hey, like you can up there, huh? No one better.
First delivery to him on the way. Line towards center field. That gets down, and the inning continues.
Hey, way to drive that one. Nice grip.
Hey, Dan, as a former pitcher, that knock just took him to a 12-game hit streak. Is that in the packet when you're looking over the lineup?
Hey, there's no doubt about that, D-Ro. You go into a pitcher's meeting, and they'll make him fully aware of who's hot and who's not. And trust me, they knew that he had an 11-game hitting streak. And after that knock, it's an even dozen.
And he'll dive back. Back in. Three runs already home here. Runners going. Swinging a soft liner. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Joshua Stewart. He singled his last time up. First pitch of the at-bat. Oh, that one got the pitcher. Thankfully, he's able to recover, and he gets the second out at first. And with that play over now, time to... So bases are empty here with two gone, and the next to bat is speedy Adam Eaton. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. Throw in time, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. They're down 7-1. Ready for another chance? Joshua Stewart, as the switch hitter, will take his cuts left-handed here. First pitch on its way. There's a swing and a high, deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. A bullet to first base. The tag will get him coming back to first. It's a double play. So the Red Sox lineup turns over and to the plate, Joshua Stewart. And their runners at the corners now. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. This is pulled into right. But a little unlucky there as it's hit right to him in right field. Mariners are down to their final out now. And up next, the speedy D. Gordon.
Gordon.
Here's the 0-1 pitch.
One.
For a base hit here as he gets this one down. And he'll step on first for the out, and the ball game is over. 8-2 tonight's final. The Bo Sox took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Rick Porcello gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Kevin Gausman was hit hard to the tune of seven earned as he takes the loss. So that's a wrap here tonight for Mark DeRosa.
A player is encouraged to get all he can out of his given talents. A coach presses a player to keep raising the bar.
Tuesday Night Baseball set to come your way from Fenway Park in Boston.
Tonight, it's in.
Rick Porcello will be on the mound for the series opener. What's your take on him, Dan?
Ball four, take it down. He's out. Out.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Willy Adames. And a great chance here for the Rays to add on in just the first inning.
Hey, here we go.
The 1-2. On the ground to third. Devers gloves it. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the Stepping up to the plate, Joshua Stewart. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The second baseman, Joshua.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Line towards center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So it's a leadoff base hit to start the Red Sox half of the inning. Now at the plate, Michael Taylor. Back on Sunday, he picked up a hit in five trips to the plate. And perhaps sensing a hit and run may be on, a move to first. And he just manages to get his hand in.
Come on, big guy.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit high and deep to right center. Perez sprinting after it. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. And now he throws on the brakes, but he can't get back to first, and he's nailed for the second out. Big mistake there. With that, here's how the hometown Red Sox line up in this one. Who's the one to watch, Dan?
Well, Rafael Devers is looking to turn it around right now.
Matt Vaskersian back with Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac as Kevin Kiermaier settles in to start the inning. Duffy aboard here at first with nobody out. Swing and a ground ball to third, but that finds its way through for a base hit.
Boy, there's another base hit, and this is just kind of like that gift that just keeps on giving, D-Roll Bolt.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy.
The first baseman, Max.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. A double play ball to second. Four. Three, apparently, as he decides not to go after the double play that could have gotten him out of the inning. Digging in to try it again, Daniel Robertson. In his career against Porcello, he has seven hits in 32 at-bats. And on 10 occasions, been a strikeout victim. Now this is on the ground to second. Is he going to get out of this? He is. They get the four. Now at the plate, Joshua Stewart. He reached on a single in his first try.
The second baseman, Joshua Stewart.
First offering on its way. This is line to left. But coming on quickly is the left fielder to make the play for the first out. And with one away, time for a check of the standings in the American League East as you get a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play. Now in the box, Joshua Stewart. And at this point of the game, I think it's clear that the plan of attack against the top of the order has worked.
Well, when you've only surrendered one hit to the top three guys in the order up to this point in the game, you know you're doing something right, Matt. You're spot on. Whatever they discussed coming into this game has worked out beautifully.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1. That's lifted the other way out to left. Pham waits on it, one down. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Kevin Kiermaier
is put in play to the right side of the infield. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. At the plate, Joshua Stewart.
Now
he flew out in his last at-bat.
Joshua.
First offering on its way. Bounce to first.
Come on, get there, get there.
And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is... Up next for the Rays, Brandon Lowe, runner in scoring position with two gone. The set and the 2-1. Slider, and that's hit on the ground towards second. Stewart. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. And now a crucial spot. Bases loaded. Two men gone. And up next will be Willie Adames.
Here we go.
Looking to keep this a one-run game. The pit hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw on the second for the force, and the side is retired. So no close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Tampa Bay Rays took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end.
For our ball game tonight, for the victorious Rays, 2 runs, 6 hits.
Wednesday night baseball now from Fenway Park in Boston. Tonight the second. Standing in, Willie Adames. And a great chance here for the Rays to add on in just the first inning. Attempt here as he gets this one down. Choi is there, and they'll just tag him out along the first base line. Time now for a look at the Rays starting nine. Dero, how do they lock up a series victory here on the road?
Maddie, these are the lineups you want to be in. Driving to the ballpark, you got a cup of coffee in your hand, you look at the flags and they're blowing straight out. You're running to the manager's office if your name's not in the lineup. It just takes one grain on and you got a potential three-run bomb.
Just a sec now as that ball finds its way into the outfield, a base hit. And another runs across as this is now a 4-0 ball game. Striding into the box, Joshua Stewart. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The second baseman, Joshua Stewart.
First pitch of the at-bat. This is line to left. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
Hard bullet single to left field on a pitch that was kind of middle down in the zone, D-Row, and he's going to have to make some better pitches than that one.
Yeah, if he's going to leave pitches over the heart of the plate, he's going to have a long night. The middle of this order does serious damage.
And he got him. With that, here's how the hometown Red Sox line up in this one. Dan, who do we keep an eye on?
Well, you have to be really impressed with what J.D. Martinez does for this offense. He had over 100 RBIs last year. That's the goal of every big hitter. If I can drive in 100, that means I had a good year, and I would say he had a pretty good year.
Here we go now. Come on now. One time.
The 3-0. And he misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away. The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. Previously against Carlos Rodon, he hasn't had much success, just 2-for-11. Now a spin and another throw back to second. And he'll get back in safely. Line drive to left. That's in there. Base hit.
Take a look at this again in slow motion. He tracks this thing all the way, gets his hands quickly through the zone, and just rips it down the left field line. Just how they draw it up.
Rafael Devers.
And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score. Settling in now, Matt Duffy. He's got to be looking for vengeance after getting plunked in his last at-bat. Liner toward right center. Oh, and this deflects right off him.
Well, Matt, as we take a look at his line here, he might not know all the specifics, but he knows he hasn't been pitching all that well in this one. Sometimes it happens.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Joshua Stewart, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. He's set, and the pitch. Tight break with the slider there, catches the inside for a strike. Dan Dero, we take a look at the Rays entering play here tonight. They've been in a nice little groove, winning three of their last four games.
Yeah, Matty, this team is starting to really come together. They won last night. They're playing really nice. I expect much more of the same today.
Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. Pham is going to get back, and he'll put this one away on the warning track for the first out.
Okay, here's how the Rays set up on defense today. And let's take a look at center fielder Kevin Kiermaier. Multiple gold gloves.
So the lineup flips now over back. And digging second in, baseman. Joshua Stewart.
Let's go. One time.
From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Foul ball.
Come on, kid. Get on for us. Here we go.
0-1. Here it comes. Takes this the other way to right. And that's in there. Base hit. And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out. Stepping up now, Michael Taylor.
The center fielder, number three. Michael A.
Needs a punch out here. Can he get it? Ground ball to second. This could be two. Barehanded for one. On to first, and they get them both. Into the box, Cedric Mullins. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far.
All right, come on now.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Hard on the ground towards second. Throw gets him, two down. In now, Willie Adames. He was retired after popping out in his last at bat.
Willie Adames.
Is put in play to the right side of the infield, and an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. So stepping in, Joshua Stewart. He singled his last time up.
Stewart.
Sent on the ground out to second. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning. So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter, Max Muncy. Hard on the ground to second. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And he is in there. So striding in, Daniel Robertson, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Well, this will be pulled in out there at second base, and that'll be that.
Leading off for Tampa Bay, the catcher, Jed Jerko.
Sliced hard on the ground. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Rays down to their final out now, and that means the corner infielder Matt Duffy will bat next.
Duffy.
Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. A swing, and he pops him up, and this should do it. Stewart is there, makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Hey, one of the keys to having a good record in baseball is to win some games at home. So this was a big win to win at home in front of their home crowd.
And tonight's one-run game comes to an end, 6-5, the final.
For the victorious Boston Red Sox, 6 runs, 11 hits, 1 error.
Now from Fenway Park here in Boston, we celebrate Jackie Robinson Day with a great matchup between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Boston Red Sox. Major League Baseball on the show starts now. Jaime Barilla starts the game on the mound for the third and final game of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, it's not too hard to figure out why this guy's one of the top pitchers having a big year. Look at that ERA, sub 1.0 ERA on the season. He's been nearly untouchable up to this point. And we should have a fun time watching this guy do what he does on the mound today in this one.
Digging in now, Joshua Stewart. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And guys, the Rays, as they begin play here this afternoon, they come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've dropped five of their last eight ball games.
Matty, we've seen some good baseball in the first two games that is set, and expect another close one here. Both of the first two games decided by one run.
You know, D-Roll, when you get in these series like this, when one run means so much, you like to be able to beat the team to score first. But both these games have been very close, and it's going to boil down to who gets the big hits in the seventh, eighth, and ninth inning.
Pulled high in the air out to left field. Moving under it, Pham. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. With that, here's how the hometown Red Sox line up in this one. Anybody catch your eye, Dan?
Well, I'm definitely excited to watch Rafael Devers in this one. He's really excelled against right-handed pitching this season, hitting over 300 against them coming in. So given the matchup he's faced with here, I wouldn't be surprised at all to see him make some noise at the plate.
And the slider gets him swinging, two gone. The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in, and he's looking to snap out of what's been a rather dry spell at the plate. The 0-1, runners off for second, line to the right side, and that'll get down for a base hit. And they won't even attempt to run on that arm in right, so despite the runner moving on the pitch, it'll wind up first and second here.
That pitcher's got to be shaking his head right now. You got to tip your cap right there. I'm still always impressed when offensive players are able to come out of the zone and still be able to make hard contact.
Come set, the 0-1. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Moving under it, Mullins. And that retires the side. Now at the plate, Joshua Stewart, the reigning batting champion in the American League.
Joshua Stewart.
Here comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Smoked on the ground up the middle. That's through for a base hit. He's now two for two in this one.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Perez waits on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Here's J.D. Martinez, 0 for 1 here in the early going.
J.D. Martinez.
Swing and a line drive. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away. Bases are loaded here with one away. And up next, the exciting left-handed bat of Andrew Benintendi. Challenge pitch coming. Here it is. And this is swung on and missed. Oh, a huge punch out there as the bases remain loaded with two away now.
Now batter.
So the bases are loaded here, two men gone, and that brings up the third baseman, Rafael Devers. Goes down to get this thing as this is lifted in the air to straightaway left. Pham is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope. Now at the plate, Joshua Stewart. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, baseball is a game of adjustments, and it's time they start making some. They don't need to change their entire approach necessarily, but now is maybe when they start thinking about ways to get the guy on the mound out of his rhythm a bit.
Swing, line, drive. That's going to be trouble. Running hard, he's digging for second. And he is into second base with a double, his third hit this afternoon.
Well, back in the day, you would hope your leadoff man can work a walk or leg out an infield single, but not in today's game. Now they expect the leadoff hitter to have a little pop, just like this guy. Nice leadoff double.
Now to the plate, Michael Taylor. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. Drilled right back up the middle. There is Jerko, and there's one away. Next will be the designated hitter, J.D. Martinez. It was a single for him in his last at-bat.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. But pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Andrew Benintendi, runner in scoring position with two gone.
Benintendi.
Now the payoff pitch home. Smoked on the ground left side. And that's through into left field for a base hit. A runner from third comes across to score as they try and chip away at their deficit. It's a 6-1 game. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Joshua Stewart. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run, get you a ribby.
But pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out. So coming to the plate, Adolfo Perez. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Comes set with the 0-1. On a rope to the second baseman. But the runner is back in time to avoid the double play. To the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Daniel Robertson. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate here, he feels good building off that last AB.
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. At the plate, Joshua Stewart starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point. But these guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional. You know, D-Row, when he makes a phone call after the game and call his parents and say, hey, he had a four-hit day, you think he's going to tell them about that infield single right there?
Oh, no, that was a line drive in the gap. We always used to say on the bench, Dan, anybody could get three hits in a big league game. You got to get that fourth one. That's what separates you. Those are the special moments.
Into the box now, J.D. Martinez. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at-bat. And he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow! So here's the Boston cleanup hitter, Andrew Benintendi. Last time through was a base hit.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield.
Catch is made, and the Rays have taken the rubber match of this three-game set as this ball game is over. 11-3, the final score in this contest. The Rays posted 11 runs on the scoreboard when it was all said and done. Jake Faria takes the win on the mound, his second of the year. Jaime Barria only completed two innings and is charged with the loss. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching...
as it can be, and I need you here with me. When you lift me up, I know that I'll never fall. I can speak to you by saying nothing at all. Every single time I find it harder to breathe, 'cause I need you here with me. Every day you're saying the words that I want you to say.
manager confronts his club about an unacceptable team statistic.
Always a treat to see a daytime ball game here, Fenway Park in Boston, Mass. Today we've got a contest out of the American League East. Chris Sale will be on the bump for game two of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, Matty V, one of the things, if you like strikeouts, this is the guy you want to watch pitch. Swing and miss stuff, good fastball, a good assortment of breaking pitches, one of the best strikeout pitchers in the game of baseball right now.
Digging in, Joshua Stewart. He'll lead things off here in the bottom
leading
half of the first.
For the Red Sox, the second baseman, Joshua Stewart.
Put a good swing on it. Here we go.
First delivery to him on the way. To short, hit hard. Gurriel over to his left. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang-bang play at first. With that, here's how the hometown Red Sox line up in this one. Mark DeRosa, tell us about digging in for his second at-bat, Joshua Stewart, the reigning batting champion in the American League. First offering on its way. Grounded weakly down the line toward third. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Line drive snagged on a short hop. And there are two away now.
Oh, man, you can't hit a ball any harder than that. I mean, this ball gets on it.
Striding in for Boston, Joshua Stewart. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far.
Stewart.
From the stretch. On the ground to second base. This could be two. There's one. On to first, and how about that? He comes right out of the bullpen and gets the double play ball with one pitch. Stepping in for the Jays, now number 15. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here. Looking to wiggle out of this here at line, but a hop. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. So striding forward now, Joshua Stewart will swing it from the left side right here.
One of the things this guy would like to do from the left side is swing it a little bit better against right-handed pitching. This guy has decent numbers, but not great numbers against right-handed pitchers.
And that'll get down out there. And add one more as this is now a 6-0 ball game. And this will get in there too late. He's in there at third.
Hey, Dero, there's a prime example of a little ambush piece, right? Come up there looking to hit right off the get-go. First pitch comes in, whack, base hit.
Yeah, you want to know if this guy was ready to go? He had a game plan. Hashtag ambush. Here we go now.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Yomer Sanchez becomes out number two this inning.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher, you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good...
And the right fielder is there to make the catch. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Blue Jays lineup. Stepping in, Kyle Santiago. He's gone hitless in this one, Dan, and he's not alone.
This lineup has had no answer for their opponent on the mound.
And that's the second out. Getting late. Eighth inning now from Fenway with the Red Sox. 6-0, the final shutout score today. Boston led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Chris Sale with his fourth win this season. Ryan Borucki was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for... Sunday afternoon. Rick Porcello, a right-hander from the Garden State of New Jersey, gets the ball here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
This guy's a pretty good pitcher, and I was looking through the stats, and one thing jumped out at me, a sub 1.20 whip coming into this start. That tells me a couple of things. One, he's not afraid to throw strikes, and two, when he does throw strikes, he throws quality, and he still gets people out. It'll be fun to watch this guy work in this one today.
With that, here's how the hometown Red Sox line up in this one. D-Row, what's the word on the... Digging in, number 15 in his career against Porcello. He's a 333 hitter. He's taken him deep once. This is popped up. And he'll go to second here. Oh, he may have been a little disoriented there or something. That's going to allow his man to reach first safely. So that'll bring in Teoscar Hernandez. It's been a really slow start to the season for him, as you can see by the April on your screen. Base hit into right center. And that runner will go no further than second, as there are two aboard now. So the base is empty here with one away. And that'll bring up Anthony Alford.
Anthony
towards second. To his left, Stewart. Throw on to first, and Porcello's looking good here. Two away. Coming to the plate now, Joshua Stewart, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
Really doesn't matter what side the plate of this guy bats from. He hits very well. He hits right-handed pitching very well, swinging left-handed, and swinging from the right side against lefties. The numbers are quite the same. This guy flat out can hit from either side.
Coming forward now, the Toronto designated hitter, Richie Parrish. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Grounded to short. This could be two. To second. On to first, and they get the double play. Ready now, Joshua Stewart. He'll swing it from the left side right here.
Loves hitting left-handed off of right-handed pitchers. Hitting over 300 against right-handed pitching.
Lying toward the gap in left center. That's in there. Base hit. And the run's going to come into score from second as they grab a 2-0 lead now. Riding in once again, now Michael batting. Taylor. Center two men on, two away
Michael
here in the fourth.
A. Taylor.
Here we go, kid.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Waiting on it is Hernandez. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Digging in, Henry Aller. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
The third baseman, Henry Aller.
Now this is slowly hit to short, probably too slowly to get two. One there, on to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. Ready once again, Joshua Stewart. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat.
Stewart.
First pitch on its way. No balls and a strike to count.
When that thing goes whistling into the stands, you hope someone brought their glove and is able to get leather on it.
Hit sharply toward the right side. Alford back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone. Next to bat for Toronto, Bruce Maxwell. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Stewart takes it in. And he'll step on first for the out, and the ball game is over. 5-1, the final total in today's game. The Boston Red Sox led this game from the third inning on and never wavered.
It was
top, let me tell you, I think's really gone wrong. These days it's all wannabe singing someone else's song. Everybody's doing the same damn thing. Where have the rebels gone?
Wednesday night baseball coming your way from Progressive Field in Cleveland. Stepping up to the plate, Joshua Stewart. He'll get us started in this one under the lights.
The second
first pitch of the at bat.
Joshua.
Hit out towards second.
Stewart.
And the inning begins with a quick out number one. And now here's how the visiting Red Sox line up in this one. Dero, how do they lock up a series victory? Stepping in, Joshua Stewart. Yes, he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. First delivery to him on the way. Turned on down the line. But this is foul for the first strike.
Hey, your pitch, drive it deep, huh? Here you go.
Comes set, the 0-1. Lifted the other way out to left center. Naquin will get there, and he puts it away to retire the...
Indians due to hit here in the third, and they are looking to get some momentum going with the bats. This is a group that has had trouble...
Into the box now, Joshua Stewart. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only two hits so far, Matt, and not very many hard hit balls either. We'll see if they can...
And that is into right field, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
You know, as a former infielder, Danny, they always say you can't be in two places at once, but you got to be a little frustrated right here that ball found the hole.
Yeah, that's a tough thing. You make a quality pitch, and a guy shoots one through the right side, normally a vacated spot right there. 9 out of 10 times, somebody's there to make that play. Unfortunately, not, and now we've got a couple of guys on.
And this is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
The designated hitter.
Here's J.D. Martinez. Past history with Mike Clevenger. Just a couple of matchups. No hits in two at-bats. On a rope to the second baseman. On to first. A double play. A hit and an error in the inning, but they failed to score. On to the bottom of inning number. So now Carlos Santana. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Yeah, and I'm sure he'd like a base hit of some sort right here, Matty. But hey, you know what? Another flyout wouldn't be all that bad. If he can get it deep enough, he should be able to drive in a nice run with a sack.
Line drive. That's a base hit into the right center field gap. Oh, and he misses it. And that'll bring in the San Diego product, Bradley Zimmer. It was a two-bagger for him in his last at-bat.
Yeah, it's been an offensive explosion for him today. There's a fight at the... Everyone seems to be putting barrel on base.
Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side... Ready for another shot now, Joshua Stewart. He singled his last time up. He's set. Here it comes. Ground ball to second. This could be two. There's one. On to first. It's a double play. As their woes continue, the inning is over. One hit's all they get. Striding in for the Indians, Kevin Plawecki. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far.
Plawecki.
And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. A 7-0 shutout final score tonight. The Tribe took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Cleveland Indians, 7 runs on...
There is rain in the area, but we've been given the go-ahead to get this one started. Today, it's the... Stepping in, Joshua Stewart.
Hey,
he will lead this one off today.
Off the afternoon for Boston, the second baseman, Joshua Stewart.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. So, fellas, this Indians ball club, as they begin play here this afternoon, 4-2 over their last 6 games, including a win last time out.
Hey, Matty V, you know, if there's such a good thing as splitting a series, Dero, this is the one. They lose the first 2 games of the series, win game 3. They like nothing more.
Hey, So digging in now, Joshua Stewart, 0 for 1 here in the early going.
Joshua Stewart.
Carrasco pauses. First pitch on the way. Lifted into center field. Naquin's on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. And that'll bring in
for the Indians, the left fielder.
In now for Cleveland, Kevin. Now batting.
Now batting. Center fielder, Tyler.
Stepping into the box, Joshua Stewart. Two men on, two away here in the fourth.
One time.
Stewart.
Come on, Daddy, like a big dog. Right
first
time,
pitch
right
on
time.
Its way. Now a ball lying toward the alley in left center. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And the runner from second is in to score. It's a 3-2 ball game. Coming to the plate now, Jordan Luplo. Flied out in his first at-bat, so making 0 for 1 so far. Now the payoff pitch home. Hard hit ball to second. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And he's going to beat the offline throw to first as the first baseman couldn't get the foot back.